of why we are here today. It's Mr. Streetball himself. You talk about turning down the NBA. You talk about the Chicago Bulls in 1970. You talk about cracking Norm Van Leer. You talk about hanging on the fence and not being able to get in the park. You talk about standing outside from 1 o'clock till 6 o'clock because Pee Wee Kirkland was playing. You talk about Tiny Archibald, Dr. J, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, Julius Erving, Oscar Robertson, Charlie Scott, you name it, Pee Wee cracked. And I'm not saying that because he's here. I'm saying that the history of streetball has to be told. It's just a pleasure. You know, we talk about Pee Wee Kirkland coming to the game with the prettiest chicks you ever seen. You talk about Pee Wee Kirkland riding up and down 7th Avenue with a Duesenberg after giving you 70. Talking about Pee Wee Kirkland playing alongside Joe Hammond when Joe Hammond destroyed everything in this country. When every pro that came to Rucker Park had to go through Pee Wee Kirkland. When Tiny Archibald, when Charlie Scott, when all our forefathers came to Rucker, they came for one reason. And it was because Pee Wee Kirkland. 135 points, 100 points, any record that we have basically goes through Pee Wee Kirkland. So Pee Wee, we're not gonna hold you too long. I know you go through this in every park. I've seen it where people have waited online to take your picture. It's still a celebrity factor with you, and you look great, and I just want to hear from you.
It's different, that's for sure, because when I played, there wasn't no such thing as a point guard or a two guard or, you know, bottom line, the coach told me to get on the court, I just got on the court to score 50. And if I scored 50, I know I did well. But if I had a real good night, that 50 turned into 60 or 70 real easy. And back then, it was different from the way it is now, pro players. It was different. They touch y'all going to the baskets and foul. Guess what? They was hanging on my neck and pulling my shorts off and everything else. You understand what I'm saying? But there wasn't no complaining. You got to go. You got to, whatever it is, it is. I love the game of basketball. Today, as much as I loved it back then when I played. But the reality it is that basketball would exist nowhere, not in New York, not in all the boroughs of New York, not nowhere in the world if it don't be for street basketball. If it don't be for these guys, brothers, sisters, mothers, uncles, all about street basketball, we can't forget that. I like ball because ball did something different. It made millions of dollars, but guess what? This youngster just won the dunk contest. Look at his size. And I said, I know he got it because somebody may be dunk. That's a little taller, but look at his size. Remind me of Spud Webb years ago, or Earl Manigo. The guy that would cup dunk the ball on 7-footers. I'm talking about those were the days, but I still love the game because that I could get guys in the game. Please listen. Stop going places and working out where everybody's doing the same thing. Because if everybody's doing the same thing, how the hell are you going to be better than them? Years ago, when everybody went to the camp, I'd go in the gym and work on crossover, work on reverse crossover. Yeah, I invented the crossover, invented the spin move to the basket. And I'm not talking about the spin dunk, I'm talking about the spin in the air jump shot from where the top of the key is to win the game. And I invented the backwards crossover, but I ain't getting credit for it yet because ain't nobody in the NBA did it. A lot of things started back, like you said, my backcourt partner, Joe Hammond. We scored 100 points in almost every game we played. We played against the pros, but Joe used to look at me and I look at him. And I know no matter who went, we bringing 100 in the backcourt. See what I'm saying? So I look at the great backcourt players today and I wish it was a time where Pee Wee Kirkland and Joe Hammond could have played against Kyrie.
And who?
And Curry.
What?
Brother, let me tell you something. That's right, I'm serious. Because it was like, I remember when Julius Erving first came and said, man, y'all played against Dr. J. I looked at Joe, he looked at me. When the game was over, we had 103.
Yeah.
And every year, when the Doc played there, I'm not saying the Doc ain't a great player, because he is. But guess who led the league in scoring every year he played there? Pee Wee Kirkland.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? Because I'm saying it ain't about your size, it's about your heart. Because when I came to bring the heat. You know, somebody put an article about me in Slam Magazine. He said that Pee Wee was the nasty MF. And I'm waiting for you to hit me, shit. I'm trying to take you out of here. And that's how we play. And today, they look for a float and a runner. One love, guys. One love.
It's the legendary Pee Wee Kirkland, Bobby C. every park, everywhere he goes. Pee Wee Kirkland, Mr. Basketball in New York City.
That's some crazy shit, but I'm jumping in.
Thanks for coming out, obviously. Somebody
asked over
there,
man, suppose you
enjoyed it. So the 2018 ball, All-Star game coming up. This is a special moment for me, Bobby. You know, I'm an all-time ball. I saw a beat Pee Wee playing. Is this always a cheap to get him up here?
It just means that I study great defense. So when I first saw Jordan, I knew his recovery time was better than anybody. But when he recovered, I ain't there.
DJ Unique,
and I don't give a fuck how you jump or fast you are. Nobody can stop a head fake or freeze. Mm. And when I get ready to lay it up, you gonna block it, I'm gonna be sitting in your fucking chest. Mm.